3 months ago, I made a video called Why I Quit Video Games. Today, I'm going to make a video called Why I Quit Video Games and Start Playing Again. If you haven't seen the video, here's a quick link to the video. Go ahead and check out the video. And I want to say everything I've said and mentioned in that video still applies. I think it's important to play video games in moderation because there is a lot more out there to life. But today, I want to talk about it being okay to be imperfect. So the first thing is, well, obviously I said I quit video games and I started playing again. So what the heck, Richard? What's up with that? And for the past 3 weeks, I've actually been playing a lot of video games, about 10 hours a day. Normally I'd be very ashamed to talk about these things, as I mentioned in my previous video, but I'm gonna be very open about it because I realize it's okay to not be perfect. And the thing I'm trying to get over, the reason why I like talking about this subject and the reason why I'm not gonna regret posting this online for the world to forever be online is because it's okay to be imperfect, and this is who I am at this current moment, and what could I learn from this exact moment right now? So that's why I'm talking about this topic. Now, right here I have my 2013 World Championship League of Legends t-shirt that I got a year ago by attending one of the professional gaming matches. This is my first time I've ever worn this t-shirt. I've been obviously very embarrassed to wear this, so here it is right here. I also brought with me things that most people haven't seen. Here we got a little Poro snack, a little cupcake, look, it has a cool little face on it, and right here we got the Ziggs Bomb, and they're just little pieces in the game. The reason why I want to openly talk about this is, whether you're a gamer or not, this is just a video for you to be okay to express yourself. Now, some people might be thinking, okay, Richard, you look like a ridiculous monk or something like that, but it's okay. No offense to monks, there's nothing wrong with them either. This is the first word that came to my mind. Another reason why I created this video is because as a speaker, as a coach, I think the most important thing is for me to be authentic with myself, because I need to understand myself first before I could help other people. And that is why I made it okay for me to play so many hours of video games for the past 3 weeks. It's not something I plan to do for the rest of my life, but I let myself just be myself. And along the way, along the past 3 weeks, I started questioning, like, why do I play video games? Of course, video games are addictive by nature, but what else, what is it to it? Is it a skill development? Is it something positive? Or is it something that I'm trying to avoid? What I realized is it's a little bit of both. It was a little bit of me trying to accomplish and develop a certain skill. I think games is a great way to work on your mental capacity, read other people, and really understand certain situations. And also, it was a way to avoid real life stuff. For me, it was the fear of rejection, the fear of failure, the fear of these expectations of what it would be like for me to become a life coach and a speaker. And it was kind of me escaping. And now that I've had the past 3 weeks, in this current moment, right now, you could ask me in a week or so, I'm sure it'll be completely different, but I see myself still playing video games, but slowly transitioning into real life stuff, helping other people, because I know that's what really drives me, that's what's important to me, and that's why I'm making these videos every single week, and I'm not going to stop doing them for at least 52 videos in a row a year. A year's worth of video, because that's my goal, and I want to keep them going because I think a lot of people have been responding back to these videos, and a lot of positive comments, a lot of reaching out, and a lot of great conversations with people. So thank you so much for your support. And at the end of the day, I think the most important thing to recognize is that there's no one right answer to life. You know, just because a lot of people think this is the right answer does not mean it is the right answer. So that's the greatest thing I love about life, is that each person is entitled to their own opinions and judgments and whatever it is. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week. All right.
Boom.
Oh, I messed that up. One more. Boom. Today I'm gonna share with you one of my deepest, darkest secrets I've had. This is among my top three. It might not seem like a big deal to you, but to me, this is literally one of my top three secrets that I've been holding in since like high school, college, and 2-3.